National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon will talk to senators about their call to remove Lieutenant General Antonio Parlade as spokesperson of the Anti-Communist Insurgency Task Force. That's after Parlade insulted legislators and linked some of them to communist groups. Esperon has coordinated with Senator Panfilo Lacson, who had said an active member of the military like Parlade is barred from holding a civilian post, such as his role in the National Task Force to End Local Communist Armed Conflict. Esperon also wants to send a letter to Senate President Vicente Soto III and consult with Senator Ronald De La Rosa on the matter.
Wala naman kaming deadline na ibinigay sa sarili namin. Ang objective namin yan ay kung paano mabigyan ng karampatang tugon yung sentiments ng Senado. At sasabihin din namin yung aming tugon dahil parang nadadamay yung pondo ng National Task Force LCAP daw.
Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana declares patrols in the West Philippine Sea will continue as he denies any disagreement with President Rodrigo Duterte on how to handle China's intrusions into Philippine waters. Lorenzana says Duterte's orders are very clear and they are to defend what is rightfully the country's without going to war and to maintain the peace in the seas. Malacanang also insists Duterte is not setting aside Manila's claim. Palace spokesman Harry Roque, however, says the president must be calculated in his statements and actions since the dispute must be resolved through peaceful and legal means. But for retired Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio, there are many ways of enforcing the country's arbitral victory without resorting to violence.
To do this, we must explain to the peoples of the world not only the arbitral award, but also the history of the South China Sea, to show that China never owned or possessed the South China Sea at any time in its history. We have the truth and law on our side. We shall win this historic battle.